How's everybody doing? Speedfree 2010 here. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to session number 33, A-Class License Part 5 of my Burnout Paradise playthrough. So ladies and gentlemen, at the end of the last video, we got the takedown racer 4x4 from Hunter, and that's what I'm going to be using to get the last 4 cars of the A-Class License. So sit back, relax, like, share, subscribe, follow, feel free to check out my Twitter, comment down below and all that if you want. And as always, I hope you all enjoy. That's all I have to say for now. And with that being said, let's get started.
Race south to Lone Stallion Ranch. Race northeast to the country club. survive the drive west to the Crystal Summit Observatory. Race southeast to the Wildcats baseball stadium. The Carson 500 GT is now on the streets of Paradise City. If you see it, shut it down to add it to your car collection. The Carson 500 GT has been delivered to your junkyard.
Okay, the Carson 500 GT. It's not much to go out this car, but I'll explain it anyway. Basically, take the Janssen X12, make it faster, but put it in a older body style. Basically, make it look like a Ford GT40 of the 60s, and give it the exact same handling and strength. So that's basically what this thing is.
Thank you.
Drive west to the wind farm. The clock is ticking. You beat the time, so you get a new car. The Carson Racing 500 GT awaits at a junkyard near you. Congratulations. Race northeast to the country club. Race southeast to the Wildcats baseball stadium. Race west to the wind farm. We'll be right back. race south to Lone Stallion Ranch. Race east to the Naval Yard. Keep your eyes open for the Hunter Racing Oval Champ driving around the streets. If you see it, shut it down to add it to your car collection. The Hunter Racing Oval Champ has been delivered to your junkyard.
Wow, I couldn't have planned that better if I tried. Alright, this is the last car of the A-Class license, and one of my favorites. One of my top fives, the Hunter Racing Oval Champ. Originally known as the Etnis Racer from Burnout Revenge. This thing is really, really fast in a straight line, but drifting with it, like it says, is uncomfortable. Dude, in terms of a possible basis, this is obviously a stock car. More specifically, a 2007, NASCAR as part of the last year of the Gen 4 era of that particular model. The front end is from the Ford Fusion, while the tail end is from the Chevy Monte Carlo. And much like the Carson Annihilator before it, it has no headlights up front but working taillights in the rear. It actually also has a community fan-made skin in slots 4, 5, and 6. Definitely one of my favorites. It also can hit you pretty hard, despite its lackluster average to below average strength rating.
Drive east to the waterfront plaza. The clock is ticking. Isn't everything, someone once said. Well, they were wrong, of course. I'm DJ Atomica, and I only salute the fastest of the fast. Drive east to the waterfront plaza. The clock is ticking. Congratulations! You earned your Burnout driver's license and won a new car. But the ride isn't over yet. Complete all events in Paradise City to earn the Burnout Elite driver's license. That car was built for speed, but even so, that was some performance. And your reward has been dropped off for you at the junkyard. Celebrate upgrading your license with a new car. The Carson GT Concept has been delivered to your junkyard.